Good morning, students. So in today's class, let's come. We'll discuss about the exploitation of Indians by the British. So exploitation of Indians. Exploitation of Indians by the British. So how the Britishers use the Indian people in a wrong way? So let's come, we'll see. Once they were firmly established in India, the British started using many unfair means to achieve their aim of getting rich. So when the Britishers are able to establish the East India Company in India, the British became selfish. To achieve their aim of getting rich, they have started doing many unfair things with the Indians. The British began exploiting the farmers. The Britishers began exploiting the farmers. The Britishers started exploiting the farmers. Indian farmers had to pay heavy taxes irrespective of the yield they produced. Whatever the yield the Indian farmers were produced, the Indian farmers had to pay heavy taxes on their yield. So as a result, they become very poor. Because of this heavy tax, the Indian farmers became very poor. Similarly, the weavers were forced to sell the cloth they produced at a very low price. And also the weavers, weaver means who produce the cloth. Similarly, the weavers were forced to sell the cloth they produced at a very low prices. And the weavers also forced to sell their cloths in a very low prices. And the weavers also forced to sell their cloths, whatever the cloths the produced by the Indian weavers. So they also forced to sell their cloths at a very low prices. The Indian cotton industry was also a victim of British greed. So the Indian cotton industry, it is also a victim of the British greed. The Indian cotton industry was also a victim of British greed. So the Indian cotton industry, it was the victim of the British selfishness. Greed means selfish. Britain did not grow cotton due to cold climate, but they had a big cotton textile. Which required cotton. So Britons are not able to produce cotton because in Britain they can see very cold. In Britain climate is very cold. So Britain people were not able to grow cotton. But still Britain had the cotton textile mills. So for the cotton textile mills to produce the cotton cloth, They need a cotton. The Indian Britain did not grow cotton due to cold climate. So due to the cold climate, so Britain were not able to grow the cotton. But still they had a cotton, big cotton mills. For that, they need cotton. But they had big cotton textile mills which required cotton. So cotton was bought at a low price from the Indian farmers and exported to Britain. So Britain people are not able to grow cotton, but still they had a big cotton textiles. So for that they need a cotton. So Britain people buy the cotton from the Indian at a very low price, and they send that cotton to the Britain. Yeah. And they export it to Britain. That means they send that whatever the cotton they bought from the Indian at a low cost, they send that cotton to the Britain. In return, cotton cloth was sent back. They sent the cotton to the Britain, and the Britain people produced the cloth and they sent back that cloth to the India. And Britishers sold that cotton cloth to the Indians at a very high price. In return, cotton cloth was sent back and sold at a high price in India. So Britain people buy the cotton from the Indian people at a very low price and send that cotton to the Britain. And the Britain people produce the cotton cloth and they again send back those cotton cloths to the India. And Britishers sell that cotton cloth to the Indians at a very high price. The British also did not allow Indians to start their own mills or factories. So Britishers did not allow the Indians to start their mills or factories in India. So the Britishers did not allow the Indians to start their own mills or to start their own factories in India. This exploitation led to dissatisfaction among Indians and a feeling of revolt grew in them. So by seeing this all, Indians feel that they have to take revenge of this all against the Britishers. This exploitation led to dissatisfaction. By seeing this all, the Indian gets dissatisfied. It led to dissatisfaction among Indians and a feeling of revolt grew in them. By seeing this all, the Indians got angry and they feel that they have to take revenge of this all, and they have decided to revolt against the Britishers. Then revolt against the British. Then revolt against the British. People in different parts of India had been protesting against the exploitative policies of the British. The revolt of 1857, according to the historians, is an important landmark in Indian history. The revolt of 1857. 1857. It created the history in the India. So the revolt of 1857, according to the historians, is an important landmark in the Indian history. So this revolt created a history in the all over the India. What is the meaning of revolt? The main reason for this revolt is the introduction of the Enfield rifle. So rifle means it is a type of a gun. The revolt was started by the Indian soldiers in the British army. So the revolt was started by the Indian soldiers. The reason for the revolt was the introduction of the Enfield. A rumor spread that the cartridges of the rifle were greased with the fat of cows and pigs. Cartridges. What is the meaning of cartridges? Made by the fat of cows and pits. The covering of these cartridges had to be bitten off before loading into the gun. So before loading these bullets or these cartridges, before loading these cartridges or these bullets into the gun, the soldiers have to bite these cartridges by their mouth. The covering of these cartridges had to be bitten off before loading into the gun. So before loading these bullets into the gun, the Indian soldiers have to bite these by their mouth. This means that soldiers had to put the cartridges in their mouth. That means they have to put that bullets in their mouth. So before loading the bullets or cartridges into the gun, they have to bite that cartridges by their mouth. That means they have to put those bullets in their mouth. This was against the religious sentiments. So it was the against this was against the religious sentiments of both the Hindu and the Muslim soldiers. So this was again the rituals of Hindus and the Muslims. So Indian soldiers refused to use these rifles and revolver started. So the Indians, Hindu and Muslim soldiers refused to use those rifles. So because of that, this revolt was started. So Indian soldiers heard the news that whatever the bullets or cartridges they are using in the rifle, those bullets are made by the fat of cows and the fat of pigs. So before loading these bullets into the gun, they have to bind those bullets by their mouth. That means they have to put these bullets in their mouth. So it was the against of the rituals of Hindus and Muslim soldiers. Because of that, Indian soldiers refused to use those cartridges. Because of that, this revolt was started. The revolt of 1857, which began at Meerut, soon spread to northern and central India. So this revolt of 1857 spread to the northern and central India. This revolt of 1857 spread over the central India. It was joined by the farmers, craft persons and the other sections of the Indian society. So in this revolt, farmers also joined and craft persons and other Indian society people also joined to this revolt. Indian soldiers overthrew their superiors and marched to Delhi to crown Bahadur Shah Zafar. So Indian soldiers removed their superiors. Through means removed. So Indian soldiers removed their superiors and they marched to Delhi to crown Bahadur Shah Zafar, who is the last Mughal emperor. Bahadur Shah Zafar. He is the last Mughal emperor. Thank you. So Indian soldiers overthrew their superiors. So Indian soldiers removed their superiors and they fight against the Britishers to give the Indian crown to this Bahadur Shah Zafar, who was the last Mughal emperor. So Bahadur Shah Zafar, he was the last king of Mughal emperor. Last king of, he was the last king. Last king of Mughal Empire. Last king of Mughal Empire. Indian rulers such as Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi, Nana Saheb Tata Tope and Kuvar Singh joined the rebels. So Indian fighters Rani Lakshmibai, Nana Saheb Tata Tope and Kuvar Singh, they all are the Indian fighters and they joined to the revolt. So Rani Lakshmibai was a martyred and Nana Saheb continued the battle. So in this revolt, in this battle, Rani Lakshmibai was died and after the Rani Lakshmibai, Nana Saheb continued the battle. The revolt continued for 2 years before it was crushed by the British. And the revolt was continued for the 2 years. The mutiny failed because it lacked proper leadership and planning. The mutiny, the Indian soldiers failed in proper planning. The mutiny failed because it lacked proper leadership and planning. The British had better trained soldiers and superior weapons. So Britishers had better trained soldiers and also they had superior weapons. But the Indian soldiers hadn't any superior soldiers and they hadn't any weapons. So because of that, they failed in a proper planning. Also some Indian rulers helped the British. So you see, by different means some Indian rulers also helped the British. By different means some Indian rulers helped the British. Bahadur Shah Zafar was arrested and exiled to Burma. So later after that Bahadur Shah, who is the last king of Mughal Empire. Mughal Shah Zafar was arrested and he was sent to the Burma. Now it is we call that Myanmar. So Bahadur Shah Zafar was arrested and exiled to Burma. So after the Bahadur Shah Zafar was arrested and he was sent to the Burma, where he breathed his last. When Bahadur Shah Zafar arrested and was sent to the Burma, there only he died. Where he breathed his last, that means he died in Burma. His two sons were killed. And Bahadur Shah Zafar's two sons were killed, bringing the once mighty Mughal Empire to an end. So by this, after the Bahadur Jafar Shah, who was the last king of the Mughal Empire, after him, the Mughal Empire came to end. After the Bahadur Shah Zafar, after this king, the Mughal Empire came to end. The revolt was a turning point in the Indian history. So this revolt, revolt of 1857. This revolt was a turning point of the Indian history. The rule of the East India Company ended and India came under the direct control of the British crown. After that, the East India Company ended and India came under the direct control of the British crown. After the end of the East India Company, so India came under the control of the British crown. After the revolt, India realized that if the whole of India had been united, so after this revolt, Indian feel that if they joined together, they would have never, British would have never succeeded. After the revolt, Indians realized that if the whole of India had been united, the British would have never succeeded. After the revolt of 1857, the Indians feel that if they joined together, if all the Indian rulers, all the Indian kings, all the Indians joined together, they can also defeat the Britishers. So after the revolt of 1857, Indian feel that if they join together, they can also defeat the Britishers. So after the revolt, Indians realize that if the whole of India had been united, the British would have never succeeded. So after the revolt of 1857, the Indians feel that if they join together, all the rulers, all the king, all the kings, all the Indian fighters, if they, all the Indians join together, so they can also defeat the Britishers. Okay, so now your third chapter is completed. So read whatever that we have discussed in this chapter. Okay.